Myalgic encephalomyelitis is an acute onset neurological disease that has systemic effects. The onset of ME is sudden and often very dramatic. Most patients know not just the day they became ill, but the hour. Myalgic encephalomyelitis expert Dr. Byron Hyde makes the following statement about ME. The prodromal phase is associated with a short onset or triggering illness. This onset illness usually takes the form of either or any combination of the following. A. An upper respiratory illness. B. A gastrointestinal upset. C. Vertigo. And D. A moderate to severe meningitic type headache. The usual incubation period of the triggering illness is 4 to 7 days. Despite popular opinion and the vast amount of CFS propaganda out there which purports to be relevant to ME but is not, there is no link between contracting ME and being a perfectionist or having a type A or overachieving personality. ME cannot be caused by a period of long-term or intense stress, trauma or abuse in childhood, becoming run down or deconditioned, working too hard or not eating healthily. ME is not a form of burnout or nervous exhaustion or the natural result of a body no longer able to cope with long-term stress. ME is also not a type of mental, behavioural or somatisation disorder. Research also shows that it is simply not possible that ME could be caused by the Epstein-Barr virus, any of the herpes viruses, including HHV6, any of the retroviruses, including XMRV, glandular fever mononucleosis, CMV, Ross River virus, Q fever, hepatitis, mycoplasma infections, candida, food allergies, influenza, or any of the bacteria which can result in Lyme disease or other tick-borne bacterial infections. ME is not caused by thyroid or adrenal dysfunctions. That includes HPA axis and amygdala issues. ME is also not caused by a negative reaction to a vaccine or a nitric acid cycle dysfunction. ME is not a form of chemical, mold or heavy metal poisoning. When all these things are talked about as causes, what is being discussed are the hundreds of different diseases that can cause symptoms leading to a diagnosis of CFS, a misdiagnosis of CFS. What is being discussed is not ME. ME is caused by a virus with an incubation period of 4 to 7 days. There is also ample evidence that ME is caused by the same type of virus that causes polio, an enterovirus. One of the most fundamental facts about ME throughout its history is that it occurs in epidemics. There is a history of over 60 recorded outbreaks of the disease going back to 1934, when an epidemic of what seemed at first to be polio was reported in Los Angeles. As with many of the other ME outbreaks, the Los Angeles outbreak occurred during a local polio epidemic. The presenting illness resembled polio, so for some years that illness was considered to be a variant of polio and classified as atypical polio or non-paralytic polio. A review of early ME outbreaks found that clinical symptoms were consistent in over 60 recorded epidemics spread all over the world. Despite the different names being used, these were repeated outbreaks of the same illness. It was also confirmed that the epidemic cases of ME and the sporadic cases of ME each represented the same illness. Myalgic encephalomyelitis is an infectious neurological disease and represents a major attack on the central nervous system by the chronic effects of a viral infection. The world's leading ME experts, Ramsey, Richardson, Dowsett and Hyde, and others, have all indicated that ME is caused by an enterovirus. Positive PCR tests for enteroviral infection have been documented in a large percentage of ME patients that have been given this test. Gradual onset fatigued patients, which may qualify for a CFS wastebasket diagnosis, of course do not share these same test results. The evidence which exists to support the concept of ME as an enteroviral disease is compelling. An enterovirus explains the age variation, sex variation, obvious resistance of some family members to the infection, and the effect of physical activity on patients, particularly in the early stages of the illness, in creating more long-term or severe ME illness in the host. There is also the evidence that, number one, ME epidemics very often followed polio epidemics. Number two, ME resembles polio at onset. Number three, serological studies have shown that communities affected by an outbreak of ME were effectively blocked or immune from the effects of a subsequent polio outbreak. Number four, evidence of enteroviral infection has been found in the brain tissue of ME patients at autopsy.